today we'll be opening up a Power of the Force Deluxe Boba Fett.
Hit it, hit it. Get it going. Two mothers went to the park. It was kinda dark. In the daytime, Carl and Ryan in the daytime. Carl and Ryan in the daytime.
Welcome, fans, back to another exciting episode of the CCNRR show. We got a, you know, we're flipping it up this season.
Oh yeah.
And this is going to be another one of our another special show. I have to say, dude, you got the AC blasting down here. It's the first time I haven't sweated in a long time because we are rolling in the cash flow right now.
Power's back, AC's blowing.
Blowing.
I'm gonna ruin the freaking compressor.
The HVAC.
Don't even care.
I gotta wear this freaking blanket because it's so cold in here. So anyway, so today's show, before we get started, again, you have to like us, subscribe us, leave us comments, Twitter us.
I mean,
do some little tweetsies.
We have a lot of social media now.
A lot of social
media. Our 8-year-old is working extra hard.
Extra hard. We got a sweatshop going here with our production manager to get everything up, organized, and ready to go for us.
It's the future.
And he's got a lot of innovative ideas for us.
He does. He's helping us out big time.
Big time. So today's episode.
And do you want to explain the fundage
we got?
Oh,
yeah. So the fundage we got for this awesome episode. We got this giant screen.
120-inch
screen for the CCNRR show. So when we want to do some ad hoc shows.
Look at the size of that thing.
Look at that. I mean, who are those hot fellas?
Look at that, dude.
Look at that. And that was I had to wear that because the sun was so hot that day.
So we got a sweet new projector and big screen. We can watch Star Wars movies on it now.
Yep.
Maybe one day we can do an episode where it's like Mystery Science 3000.
Yes.
Where you and me watch a whole episode.
A whole episode.
And critique and talk about it.
And we can talk about it. We can talk about what we did right and what we did wrong.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
You know? Even Bronte likes the show.
Yeah, our new mascot.
A new mascot for the show. Bronte's got a smile every day. Every day. 7 days a week.
I like it.
All right. So,
what are we doing today?
So today's episode, we are going to look at the CCNRR top 10 list of best eBay listings.
Which we love eBay.
We love eBay.
I've spent more money on eBay than I did my house.
Yes. I don't even get my kids need braces. I need my tires changed.
Nope.
But I'm spending it on eBay.
Absolutely.
All day long.
I will burn through a paycheck.
So, in fact, this is how I got Mr. Bronson.
This is how I got this couch.
You got that couch.
I got this whole couch. This whole room is eBay.
Sweet.
Everything in this room is on eBay.
Everything is on eBay.
Insane.
Big boxes. The only way to pay
extra. Would you like a treat?
No, that's okay, dude. All
right.
I don't want to break my teeth. All right. I want teeth like Mr. Bronte.
Mm.
Okay. So, today's episode, we're going to do the top 10 best eBay listings from our perspective, and we're going to do this maybe a couple times during the year
because
things get updated.
Okay,
so let's start with number 10.
Number 10.
Drum roll. Number 10. All right, so what do we got?
All right,
we have Star Wars original proof of purchase lot.
So these are the original proof of purchase.
Look at all those 120 Skrills.
I mean,
you know, I almost bought this because I wanted to get a mail-away Boba Fett, missile-firing Boba Fett from 1979, and I almost bought this. I mean, look at that. Look, now we know where all of the proof of purchases are.
So whenever you get a toy that's missing a circle at the bottom corner, this guy, look at that little one on the left. He just cut the whole bottom of the box out.
And that's an Ewok battle wagon. You know how hard it is to find that?
Those are super rare.
Those are super rare.
Look, right here. Look at this.
Look at this. Look at that. I don't even know what that says.
I can't even read it.
But it's a General Mills, so it's vintage.
It just says Star Wars action figures.
Yeah, and they even got maybe a G.I. Joe one there on the right. Action figures left and right. Look at that. So I was going to buy this, and right before I hit buy, I did make an offer because I was trying to be a little cheap. And this guy wanted 120, and I said 115,
mm-hmm.
and he came back and said 119.
Wow.
He would only take a dollar off. And at that point, I was like, you know what? Maybe the Rocket Fire Boba Fett was expired, and I probably couldn't get it.
It's crazy, because when you read the description, it says, huge lot, actual proof of purchase cutouts from the original playsets and ships and packages. It says, everything is original, Kenner. And it says, if you notice, backdrop props are display only, not included. So you don't get the backdrop props.
You don't get the props.
Yeah, you're only getting those magical cutouts.
Magical cutouts.
So that's number 10.
Number 10.
And right. And maybe we should make a disclaimer that you don't get Mr. Brontosaurus in this here, even though he's a prop. Right?
Right. Correct.
All right.
Yeah, everything you see in this room is not for sale.
Not for sale.
Gotcha. Okay?
All right, so number 9 on our list is this awesome Jar Jar Binks tie-dyed Star Wars shirt. And look how cute he looks. He's saying, hey, he's just a playful. He's just playing with us, right?
He's got a little tongue out.
He's got look his that, tongue look at that. Look how long that his tongue is. Look at, he's got his he's very
he's playful. Underwater.
He's underwater, and he's like, look at me, I'm swimming in Naboo. Yeah. He's like,
he's in the swamps of Naboo.
And he's just, he's going.
Look at the price of this.
$100.
He only wants $100.
$100.
$100 for a tie-dye Star Wars shirt with Jar Jar on it.
I know. I mean, that may be a Disney shirt, right?
I mean, according to the description, it just says that it is an extra large t-shirt and is a tie-dye new Jar Jar. It's got the tag in it.
Yeah. And he even gives you the pit-to-pit.
Yep. So you know.
Dimensions.
So you know exactly how, if you can fit into this amazing, amazing shirt.
So, do you think I can recreate this? Let's see. Look.
Does that look the same?
Let me see. Yep, I think I got it, right? It's even got the tags on.
For $100, I may have to buy that.
I do like that. And it looks like a good quality shirt. Official Jar Jar. That was official Jar Jar. All right, so number 8. Now, this one is unbelievable. So this is near and dear to my heart. You know why? Because you remember in 1997, we would go to Toys R Us and find all these figures.
Right, right.
And we saw this. We said, wait a second. I've got all of these figures. I don't have this one. This is a Luke Skywalker, Power of the Force, with a Obi-Wan Kenobi. Look at that staff. It's like a Cobra Commander staff. With like maybe like an owl tip,
what is he wearing?
He's wearing a variant suit.
I mean, I don't know what exactly his stance is.
He's got
all his limbs are different colors.
Every limb is different.
Why is the photo such horrible quality?
I don't know.
Is it because they don't want you to really see what's happening here?
Yeah, and you know, it mind boggles me that they put a staff in there that is like a walking cane.
I mean, yeah. I mean, I didn't know Obi-Wan had a cane.
Yeah.
The description literally says, clean, ready to ship. Check pictures out. I'd love to sell it to you. But I don't know what it is.
I don't know what it is, but it's clean.
I mean,
let's go back. And so there's actually two people watching.
There's that. Two watchers right now.
There's two people that are like, I'm contemplating buying this figure.
I mean, I don't see him on this description down here.
No, I see an Obi-Wan with a lightsaber.
I see Obi-Wan. I see Luke.
I mean, well, look at that Jedi Luke in that upper left corner there.
Yeah.
He's got a full black suit on.
Look at that guy. That's Return of the Jedi Luke.
Yeah.
All right.
That's a classic. 25 scrolls.
It was $25. Shipping's free, though, so.
Yeah, for that. All right, so what number are we on? We're on
7.
7.
10, 9, 8, 7.
7. All right, so number 7. This one was another good treat. So we have an R2-D2. That looks like it's been through the Clone Wars for the past 35 years. And he is pretty beat up.
Look at that shot.
Look at that shot.
He's fully articulated.
He's like, I'm getting ready for the Clone Wars part 2. You know? He's got barely any sticker left. He's got the hole on the top.
The hole's on top.
He's got no chrome left.
It's literally all just straight plastic.
But he does have, if you go to the next picture, a clean screw.
He does. The screw is not rusted.
It is not rusted.
So, if you thought there was water that caused that damage, clearly it did not.
It was the Clone Wars.
It was the Clone Wars. Look at that shot. Look at that.
And this gentleman is selling this as a very rare variant. Our favorite.
It says variant.
Yes. And when we looked at this, we were like, we need some variants to buy. This could be the variant.
It says arguably the rarest Euro no COO figure, Meccano R2.
Wow.
With sensor scope,
but there is no sensor scope.
It says obviously this one has seen better days. So at least he acknowledges that it does have some wear on it.
Yeah, because at first I didn't think it had
any. I thought it was maybe supposed to be like that.
I thought it was a variant. Right. Right.
So it's saying that though, it is literally saying that this is a super rare, and that it's not the fake ones that have been sold over the past year.
Wow.
So this is a 1977 no COO.
No COO.
So right. For somebody looking for that, it is on eBay right now. You can buy that for the mere price of $29.99 with $4.99
shipping. $4.99
shipping.
I hope they send that in a manila envelope.
I mean,
maybe with a little padding.
Let's go to my favorite.
All right.
Number
so why
six.
Why don't you do this one?
Number six is a rare original unpunched. They all know. Everyone knows how people love unpunched Star Wars toys.
Yes, I love them unpunched.
So it's a 1977 action figure toy display sign. If you notice that price, I feel like that's very reasonably priced.
Yes.
It is $16,999.99. So not $17,000, but $16,999.
Because he wanted to make sure you were getting a deal.
He wants to make sure. And crazily enough, there's 12 people watching this right now.
12 people watching.
Look at this
thing.
There
is 12 people in this world
that are watching this.
That are watching that and are like, I have $17,000.
So I guess the no punch right here is showing there's nothing punched in there.
Yeah.
So essentially all this is a cardboard sign.
And it's got a vinyl cape
Jawa.
It's
got a vinyl cape Jawa, so you know it's original.
Yeah.
Because that was an original. It's got the Luke with the telescoping lens.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's definitely original.
It is definitely original. And it's got the small head Han.
Small head Han. There's your Kenner.
There's your Kenner. And it is amazing to me that there's 17... There's how many people?
There's 12 watchers.
There's 12 watchers, and they have $17,000 to potentially
on a piece of cardboard. Essentially, if you look here, it's essentially the same things as what you see with the X-Wing and the TIE Fighter, and it's essentially something just like that. The description on this thing...
Let's see.
I mean, it says right here it's a very rare, unpunched, bell-shaped action figure display.
That's what makes the difference.
It says it was a promotional Kenner prop that was used at a toy fair to show the upcoming Star Wars toys. That's what they're saying. So this was actually an original thing that was out to display, like when they had the initial push for toys.
Right. And he had to put in here that this was not a reproduction.
This is not a reproduction.
I mean, for $17,000.
This is the original.
It better not be.
This is the original one.
A reproduction.
Yeah, this is the original one. So, right. I like it. So, yeah, not too bad.
All right, so we're on to number five.
Let me go to number five real quick and see if I can pull this out.
Okay, so here we go. Number five.
Hang on, stand by.
Stand by.
It's got to load. Sorry, I got to pull up the... There's no service in this house.
Gotcha.
Just got to pull it up.
So we're going on, and maybe we can do a little pre... Here we go. So this guy... Man, your internet. Okay, here we go. So we got an Obi-Wan, and I almost got hosed, but I do like this figure. Okay, I love me a 12-back Obi-Wan.
It's a 12-back.
Now, I don't know if anybody can see anything wrong with this figure.
Hang on.
I mean,
let me make sure I can show, see if it's an actual 12-back. Does it show?
Let's see if it shows.
There you go.
There you go. Oh, look, we get double for our money. We get
the
proof of purchase. We can get maybe from the auction.
Maybe that is one that was cut off in the original one.
Yeah, it was maybe cut off, right?
So it's gone.
So you get that back.
You get it back. But you can just put it right over the place.
Right over it, right? But look at the front. Let's look at the front of this. Let's see if anybody can see anything wrong with this. Bubble is clear.
Here we go.
Go back one more, the other picture there.
This one?
Scoot one over.
This one?
There you go. I mean, look at his arm there. And look at his legs. I mean, that is... What do you think that is?
I mean, is it cold in the room?
I don't know. Do you think that...
Was there a Wampa edition?
Maybe Obi-Wan? There was. Yeah, maybe. Or maybe a cocaine edition?
Maybe this one has... Yeah, maybe this is the coked up
Obi-Wan
Kenobi.
Yeah, after...
Here's a better shot of the front shot. Yeah.
I love me some frosting.
This guy looks like he was going through some snowfields to get to the box.
He looks like someone dipped him in some salt crystals.
Seriously.
And made a variant and put him on the card.
I mean...
Because I have to say, this gentleman was going to actually bubble wrap this.
He did.
and sell it for $900.
There's your price point, $897.
Mint in package.
Mint in package.
The frosting does not take away from the mintness.
Let's see, does he describe the frosting?
He says, new and sealed, not a fake, acrylic collector's case, good condition, proof purchase removed. Figure's arms, legs, and head are oxidized.
Mm.
Kind of looks like the ghost of Obi-Wan for Return of the Jedi. So he's actually making it like a joke.
Like an extra.
Saying it's almost like foreshadowing that this was the Return of the Jedi version. Yes,
like Kenny was actually making a new one.
And it's saying oxidation. This is not oxidized. This is covered in frosting.
And I'll say this. The deal breaker for me was not the frosting, but was his last sentence. Did you see what his last sentence
said? I did not see. What was it?
It said, dent on bubble.
Oh. Yep, dent and bubble, yep, bottom left edge.
I will take a figure covered in frost for $900.
But don't dent that bubble.
Don't dent that bubble.
Does it show the dent? I'm just curious if it actually shows it.
Let's see.
There it is right there.
There it is, dent on bubble.
Dent on bubble. Mm. Right next to the ice feet.
Yeah, I mean, that frosting actually looks a little appetizing.
I'm actually getting hungry now.
Yeah, look at that.
Notice the upper body is good.
It's amazing how that plastic works that they use, right?
All
right, so we're moving on to number four. We're getting close.
We're close.
We're at the midway point.
Which one was number four? I don't know which
This
one. Oh, stand by.
Keep going. We're almost here. There it is.
Is it this one?
It was this one. All right, so we're flipping it up a little bit. Stand by. It's got to load. I mean, we're running dial up here.
So we're going off base. This is not Star Wars.
Yeah, we're going a little different here.
All right.
So this is another line that I really like.
You used to collect these.
I used to collect this line until it was virtually impossible to find one of these figures without frosting
on it. Right.
Virtually impossible. This is an Indiana Jones figure that the gentleman wants $900 for.
$900 he wants.
Card is beautiful. Bubble is crystal clear. But that figure's got frosting all over it.
Does it?
Yeah, and you can't really see it here.
What I would love is if my
oh, there
here we go. Is that a better?
There we go. Look at his legs. Look at those legs crystallized.
Look at the glistening.
Look at the glistening on
Look that. At that. Wow.
I you know, it's almost like I want to take a pumice and shave it off.
Now you
I want to just take my wife's foot pumice and shave that off.
Now question. You look at his hat.
His hat's covered in frosting.
It looks like
he's like, get me out of here.
Now, let me ask you a question, because I didn't collect these. Mm-hmm. It's Kenner.
It is Kenner, absolutely. And you know what Kenner did with this line? They gave them bendable knees.
Really?
Yes, he's got bendable knees.
There it is. Look at that.
Look at that.
Lock in place.
And he's got an action lever hand, too. His hand actually goes like this.
I can't see in the
light. Oh, sorry. It goes like this.
Oh!
Yeah, it's got an action lever hand.
Was it a lever on his back?
No, you just jerk his arm up like that. Like that, the holster actually could fit that gun.
Wow.
And it could come right out.
So he wants a mere $950.
That's a starting bid.
Super mint plastic cover.
Let's see. Yeah.
Perfect condition, no dents. So no dents.
No dents.
Card, super mint. Says here that the mint on card.
Yeah.
And I don't see any mention here of any type of frosting. No. I see no mention.
No mention.
So he clearly doesn't think it's an issue.
Doesn't think that you spending $1,500 or $1,300 on a figure that's covered in frosting is an issue.
I'm impressed.
It's impressed.
I'm impressed.
All right.
Are we going
so
this one next?
Number three, right?
I don't even know anymore.
Yeah, this is number three. And you have a few, too, we got to quickly get through, right?
I already went through mine.
Oh, you did?
Mine were at the back of it.
That's right. All right. So this is number three. This one is a...
This is a custom...
Custom-made Yak face.
I don't even know what I'm looking at here.
Yeah, it's like a reaction alien figure.
It does look very reaction-esque.
You know? But he also has some G.I. Joe, because he's got some... a little bit of... I don't even know...
Look at the head!
It's like the alien from Indiana Jones.
Yeah.
And the Crystal Skull. And he's got some... combat gear on. Look at that close-up of that paw hand there. Bratty would like that paw
hand. What am I looking at right here?
I think that's his, like, legs. And maybe he's even got some frosting.
It looks
like
it has frosting on it.
Yeah, and he's got his squirrel tail belt on right there. Look at that head. It's, like, translucent. Unbelievable, right?
I'm impressed.
I like that figure. Right. I thought that was a good one.
And what was the price on this guy? This guy was...
Well, it's relisted, so we got to check what the relisted price is,
okay,
because so many people wanted it.
I mean, he just states that it's a bootleg, and it's molded from the original figure.
Yeah.
It's one of a kind.
Yep, one of a kind, and it was made in Afghanistan.
Oh.
Of the dunes of Afghanistan.
Okay, well, yeah. All right, well,
it's very, very classic. And he only started it at $9.
Yeah, I mean, $4.50. Most yak faces are very expensive.
Yeah,
so all right, I'm impressed.
So now we're going on to number two, almost down. I'm getting excited, right? We're getting to our top number one.
I think the top two are the best.
The top two are the best. I agree. So here is our favorite.
Our favorite,
a plush Jar Jar Binks. Now look at Jar Jar's face there. It looks like he went to the orthodontist and they chiseled the coral out of his teeth. Look at that. Means the teeth are clean.
Look, he comes with a droid.
And he comes with a droid. It's a wake-up Jar Jar. So you can actually wake up to that Jar Jar. And look at his hands. Look at his hands in that picture.
Look at his hands right here. Look at the size of those mallets.
It's like a club hand.
Look at that thing. Would you want to get hit in the head with that?
Look at that. Look at that.
And that looks like it's a Toys R Us.
The Toys R Us. Look at that classic orange symbol.
Yeah.
And then go to the next page. Look how Jar Jar's sitting in that picture.
What is he doing? Is he on a bat? Is he going to the toilet?
He may be going to the toilet because he swallowed too much Naboo water.
Yeah, that Naboo water will get to you.
Yeah. Look at him there. That is a... Who would not have bought that?
This is impressive.
I would have bought that all day long, wouldn't you?
Yeah. I mean, look at that thing.
Yeah, look at his hands.
All right. And what's the price they want for this?
Let's see.
Wow. They only want $160 for it.
$160 with $60 for shipping.
Was $60.
I would have said like $80. That's a great deal, right?
And the box quality is top notch.
Top notch.
I mean,
how many of those things you think you could find at Toys R Us?
Honestly, those are hard to find. I mean, now Toys R Us is gone. You're not going to find it anywhere.
Person's very polite. They thank you for looking at their bids.
And there's no mention of what it actually is, though. This guy is very detailed on what is allowed.
He is, but he won't tell you what it is.
No, I think it explains itself.
Yes.
I think it speaks for itself.
You look at that picture and you're like, I'm getting a Jar Jar.
All right.
So to our number one, you ready? This is the big countdown for number one. All right, here we go. It's got to load up. Should we buy this in the meantime?
I think this one we should probably buy.
Yeah, I think that would be a good one.
I hear it.
Okay. So in all of our collecting, if there's one thing we need, it's the elusive Pizza Hut Episode 1 boxes.
And these boxes are in amazing shape.
I wonder if
these did not come with the pizza, and maybe they had an insight to the store.
Maybe.
And they gave it to him saying, hey, don't put pizzas in those because it'll make it worthless.
Because there's going to be a collector that wants to buy these.
That's going to want these.
Yes. And look at that bottom left box. Look at that.
Who doesn't want that?
Who would not want
Look how happy he is. He said, Misa, bring you pizza.
Yes. Misa got some breadsticks. Misa got some pizza sauce. Look at that.
And they don't say if they've been actually delivered. Let's find out. They want $180
for that. $180
for those. Wow.
And I almost bought these. I almost went to Pizza Hut and looked for those.
This is rare set.
Rare set of four Pizza Hut
boxes. $19.99. It said the set can be framed. You can frame it.
I would frame those
boxes. So if you go back to this picture.
Let's see.
Essentially, what he's doing it for you, so you can kind of see if you wanted to hang that.
You could hang.
You could buy those and hang it in like a four box.
Yeah, and look, it actually forms.
Yeah,
Naboo. Like,
it does. It makes Naboo.
Yeah, and I wonder if there's some pizza still left.
Maybe it might be delicious.
Maybe we can do a taste test like we did with our other ones.
I think we should.
And how many watchers? There's actually four people.
There's four people right now that are interested.
Considering watching those, considering buying those Pizza Hut
boxes. I'm impressed. I like that.
Wow.
We might have to get that one and hang it up over the studio.
That would be a good project.
Yeah, we can get that for the studio, maybe.
Yeah, maybe we will.
All right.
Well, there we go. Another great episode of the CCNRR show. Look for more top 10 lists. We got plenty out there. Anything else? I think that's it for now, right?
Look at the screen. Look at that screen. Go back to that screen size.
Look at that
screenshot. Look how intense we are in that shot.
We are seriously doing some review.
So, yeah.
All right.
Until next time.
See ya. Peace.